in Yemen, in our master's MBA and master's in IT. We have, then after that, we worked with the Arab Open University in Bahrain. We also have similar program, but we also have PhD programs that are on offer. After Bahrain, we went to Maldives. We worked with a local college there, having some master's program as well as bachelor in education. Our partners are up, although they mean well, but sometimes the system, the way they do things, are different from ours. Similarly, when you have partners from overseas coming to Malaysia, from British universities, Australian universities, or perhaps American education providers, their perception about local universities, local management styles may be different. So I think we are always learning. So that's an important way of doing things when we cross borders as far as education is concerned. We have to take care of the local sensibilities, sensitivities, local rules, and I think that's important. In Yemen is different from Bahrain, from the Maldives, from Accra. And we learned that in Hungary is a bit different too. So I think these are processes that we are learning. In part, we have to be innovative. We have to think of new ways of delivery. So I think in every country that we do, we normally will allow the flexibility that should happen between the two partners. Now the other thing which I want to share with you is the development of this National E-Living Center in Saudi Arabia. We have a role to play here because we are partnering with the Ministry of Higher Education there because they want our e-learning system to be established there, which we have done actually in the last 2 years, where they're hoping that the other universities in the whole kingdom will adopt this system of ours, which we have, of course, changed a little bit to suit the needs of Saudi Arabia. Now, with the new ways of delivery, new things to be done. We all, I'm sure this happened in every ODL institution, where we look to new ways of being innovative, creative, and so on. So we leverage on all these new ways so that the learners can benefit. Because we know that learners are also innovative in their own ways. And they would like to utilize all this so that collaborative learning will become an important part of their learning process. I wouldn't want to spend much time on this, but let us look at some of the advantages that students can have, institution can have, faculty members as well as tutors that are involved in ODL particularly. Now, we can have these virtual communities between faculty members, between student and student and so on. That will encourage learning process to be creative, and I think this is important. Allow content aggregation from many learners. They're learning from each other. And they have alternative peer review and editing. These are potential alternatives to learning objects. And of course, they can have a new way of thinking. So all this, I think new technologies, utilizing new technologies, which I believe is the way forward in the future. It has encouraged ODL institutions like ours to become part of this new development. If we don't, we probably will be left behind. There are other institutions who will adopt this, and I'm not surprised that even traditional campus universities will adopt this, because the students, most of the time, they are well advanced into this. Now, ladies and gentlemen, let me just conclude by saying that, firstly, the Gartner's Five Minds, which I elaborated at the beginning, will remain important because it encapsulates the way things can be done, the way we adopt new ways, we can be creative in our learning process, because the technology that we have will always be rapidly moving ahead. And I think for us, it's important as institutions, as faculty members, to move on. And it is important that in moving forward, we always have the student as the main focus for our delivery system to reach them as well. So if we do that, I believe that we shall play an important role in the development of our human resources, whether we are in Malaysia, in other Southeast Asian countries, in Europe, or the Americas. So ladies and gentlemen, let me stop here, and perhaps we can share.